restrictions. We risk creating artificial realities where nature ceases to be truly natural. Imagine a world where plastic plant surgery becomes a reality, a practice dedicated to altering the human body in an effort to preserve a static, idealized sense of beauty. In this world, people undergo procedures designed to counteract the natural ebb and flow of beauty and decay. From the dawn of time, our flesh and the flora of the earth have been inseparable. In this existence, plants are not mere adornments. They are integral parts of us. From the moment we draw our first breath, we inhale their essence. They anchor us to the earth, their roots intertwining with our very bones. Our lungs, our limbs, our movements, each is supported by this delicate symbiosis. The green of the leaves and the bloom of the flowers aren't just beautiful. They're essential to our existence. Finding the right balance in our connection with nature is crucial as it decides whether we nurture life or push things toward destruction.
First thing that we see is the four white walls of the hospital, and then we go to school, then we are between the brick walls of the classroom, then we go to the office, and then we have the four walls, the concrete walls of the office. We die and they put us under the four walls under the ground. So I'm wondering what happened with us as humans. Didn't we miss the train of beauty of nature? So I'm not here as a climate activist. I'm more here to show the beauty of nature, what I see as a gardener in my garden, because I'm always sitting on my knees. And that is what I see, is that magic of nature. And what I try to do is not, I don't try to paint a landscape, I don't try to paint flowers. I just try to capture the force into fragility, or the fragility into that force. That is what I try to do. And when you see the empty spaces on my canvas, is that, for me, these are the sketches, is that brutalism that I just keep the space open, that you can delight in your imagination, and it's up to you to fill in what you see. And when you see the big paintings here behind, when I was painting them, I was feeling like being home, because when I was as a kid, my home was under the bushes, and it was like more an organic space. And that's why when I was painting these big paintings, I was like feeling, this is where I belong really into my garden. The same thing what you see downstairs is that with the movie and my sculptures is that what if the plants are growing outside of us would be to our best to maintain or to protect nature, and what if our flowers growing out of us will fade away? What will do? We will do like a plastic surgery and put all plastic flowers in us? So for me it's just the question is that would we take care more or better about our environment? And that is the question that I raised with the movie we made. And then the sculptures for me is like for me is that it's actually the same of my paintings. That these are flowers, and flowers where I try to capture that force of nature, the fragility of nature into my sculptures. So I'm really happy to be able to share that with you guys. And And I would say, yeah, think about it. If plants would grow out of you, how you would treat them. So, thank you.
Thank you.